Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle, and thank you for joining me. Today I want to talk about the schemes that the enemy uses against us. Where's the first place that Satan attacks us? In the natural. It's in our minds. It's in our thinking. Jesus was crucified on a hill named Golgotha, and it means the skull. He was crucified on a hill named the skull, and what we need to do is crucify every thought that is contrary to the Word of God. So how does the enemy attack us? Through our minds. First way that he does it is through lies and deceptions. There's a lot of things that smell true, taste true, and feel true, but they're still lies. They're life experiences that have promoted belief systems to us that are contrary to the truth of God's intentions and His character. We have to reject every lie and deception that comes into our mind and say no to it. We're going to continue to stand firmly believing God. And the second one is doubt and unbelief. If we believe the lie and the deception, we're going to fall into doubting God's character, doubting His promises, and doubting His word. And then we're not walking in faith, we're walking in unbelief. He will put thoughts into our mind. And the third way He attacks us is through temptation. Maybe we're tempted to yell at somebody or hurt somebody or lie or steal or cheat or whatever mankind has been known to do. There's temptation all around us, but the temptation always starts in the mind. The first thought is not sin, it's what you do with it. Say no to the temptation that comes your way from the natural, knowing that the enemy uses your natural situations and circumstances to attack your life. The next way is accusation and condemnation. The enemy wants to accuse you. It says he stands before us night and day, constantly accusing us. And we need to say no to those accusations. We are who God says that we are. We have fallen short, but we are the righteousness of Christ. So if we understand that what Jesus did for us makes us righteous, we can simply repent, accept responsibility for our failures, but not receive the accusation and condemnation. Because all of the things that we've just named create an isolation and divide us from the presence of God. We want to say no to the enemy, draw near to God, unite as a fellowship of believers, and stand firm against the enemy's schemes. This will all be done by aligning your agreements with the Word of God. This is Dr. Michelle. Thank you for this time. Please like and share.